Hari Om, dear students. Welcome to our online session. In today's session, we are going to deal with the fifth lesson of our English supplementary reader. The title of the lesson is Footprints Without Feet. And it is written by H.G. Wells. And it is really a very interesting lesson where you all will be enjoying a lot. Hope you do will enjoy it, and as I tell you very regularly, do read the lesson twice before watching the video. Okay, children? Yeah, let us start the class. Yeah, as I told you that the writer of this lesson is H.G. Wells. You can see the picture of our writer H.G. Wells here, and his name is Herbert George Wells. What is his name? Herbert George Wells, and he was born on 21st September 1866, and he was an English writer and prolific in many genres. He wrote dozens of novels, short stories, and works of social commentary, history, satire, biography, and autobiography also. His work also included two books on recreational war games. Wells is now best remembered for his science fiction novels and is often called the father of science fiction. So here, Herbert George Wells, he was born on 21st September 1866, and he was an English writer, and he is called as a most prolific writer in genres, and he had written many novels, short stories, and as well as some writings about the history, satires, biography, autobiography, and also some recreational war games. And he was well known and well remembered as the father of science fiction. It is about our author H.G. Wells. Yes, children, before starting the lesson, let me ask you a question. Can a man become invisible? Yes, children, what I have asked is real. Can a man become invisible? Can you become invisible and do all your regular chores? Is it possible? Yeah, you see in the picture here, I have given you two pictures where the body and the dress of a human being is visible, whereas the face is not at all visible. Can a human being become like this? Probably not. Am I right? Yes. But here in this story, we are going to discuss about a person who is invisible. Okay, that's why I told you that this is an interesting story. Okay, children, so this is an interesting story about a scientist whose name is Griffin, and also about his formula of invisibility. He had invented a drug which can make human beings invisible. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about the scientist whose name is Griffin, and as well as his formula of invisibility. Okay, actually he had developed a drug which makes human beings invisible. Human body is totally invisible, it becomes invisible, but he can feel the senses, but he can be physically, he can feel all the senses. Okay, he can be invisible, but he will be feeling all the senses physically. So that is what we are going to discuss here. Okay, children. So here he intakes, this scientist, this Griffin, he intakes that drug and he becomes invisible. And after becoming invisible, what does he do? That is what we are going to discuss in this lesson. Okay, children? Hope you have understood that in this story we are going to discuss about a scientist whose name is Griffin, and as well as his formula of invisibility. Like, he had invented a drug which he himself had intaken it and he became invisible. Now what he is going to do, that is what we are going to discuss in this chapter. Okay, shall we start? Let's start the lesson, children. The two boys started in surprise at the fresh muddy imprints of a pair of bare feet. What was a barefooted man doing on the steps of a house in the middle of London? And where was the man? As they gazed, a remarkable sight met their eyes. A fresh footmark appeared from nowhere. So here, children, in the middle of the London, on a street, two boys, they started in surprise. They were looking at a fresh muddy imprints. Imprints in the sense here, impressions. Impressions, okay. So here the two boys started looking at some imprints, that is impressions, which were on fresh and muddy surface. Okay. And what were the imprints? What were the impressions? Impressions of a pair of bare feet. What do you mean by bare feet here? Wearing nothing in the feet. That means no chapel or no shoes. Without chapel or without shoes, how we walk, isn't it? You can see the impressions of a bare feet here. So in this way, our footprints will be seen, isn't it? Of a bare feet. So here, these two boys, they started in surprise at the muddy surface because there were a pair of barefoot imprints, impressions. Okay. And they were surprised and they were just discussing, what a barefooted man doing on the steps of a house. So on the steps of this house, what the man is doing without shoe or barefooted man. So what this barefooted man is doing on the steps of a house in the middle of the London, both of them were discussing why this man is here and what is he doing in the middle of the London. They were discussing, and also, where was the man here? They couldn't see anyone there. As they gazed, a remarkable sight met their eyes. So when they were staring at these impressions, they have seen a remarkable sight. What is that? A fresh footmark appeared from nowhere. So human being is not at all visible, but they can see the footprints, the impressions of the bare feet. So they are there. See here, one by one the human being is walking. They could see that footprints, but there was no man. Where was the man? Man was not there. So the two boys were surprised and shocked. What is this? We can see the footprints of a barefoot on the steps of this house in the middle of the town, London. But we can't see human being. There is no sign of human here. No man is seen here. How can it be possible that only these imprints are seen? They were in shock. Further, footprints followed one after another. descending the steps and progressing down the street. So when these boys were shocked and staring at these footprints, these footprints were followed. That means the footprints were walking, just moving forward one after the other. So they are moving, descending the steps. That means moving down to the steps and progressing down the street. That means this person, the footprints are walking from the steps of the house to the steps. These footprints have come to the down of the steps and it moved down to the street. That means there is invisible man. He is walking from these steps. He had come down and he moved to the street. But these boys, they followed and they were fascinated. Fascinated in the sense, strongly attracted and interested. How can this be possible that only the footprints alone are moving? Okay, the footprints are moving in such a way that from the steps they have come down and now they are moving into the street. Huh? Is it possible? They were shocked. And see, these boys, the boys were fascinated until the muddy impressions became fainter and fainter and at last disappeared altogether. So they were following these footprints in such a way that till the footprints became fainter, fainter in the sense they became dull, 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 and then finally they disappeared. So till then, these two boys were following the footprints. See here, the boy was following the footprints in such a way that they wanted to find it out. How can this be happening? Because is it possible that only footprints can be seen without human being? It was really a shock to the children and they were surprised and they were attracted to it. How is it happening? They wanted to find it out, but finally they couldn't find it because the footprints, these impressions became fainter and fainter. That means dull, and then finally the footprints disappeared altogether. Okay? So that was really a mystery to the boys, how only the footprints can be visible without human being. So the explanation of the mystery was really simple enough. So here the mystery, what was the boys were feeling? What do you mean by mystery, children? Something that is difficult to understand or explain. So here the boys were totally shocked and couldn't find out how the things, like how the footprints were formed. But it was very simple enough. That is, the bewildered boys, bewildered in the sense puzzled or confused. So the confused boys, they had been following a scientist who had just discovered how to make the human body transparent. So the boys were following the scientist. Okay, I have already told you in the introduction, children, isn't it? So these boys were following a scientist who had just discovered a formula, that is how to make human body transparent. Once if we take that drug in, automatically our body becomes transparent or invisible. So these two boys were following the scientist who had taken that drug and he becomes transparent here. Okay? Griffin, the scientist, had carried out experiment after experiment to prove that the human body could become invisible. Finally, he swallowed certain rare drugs and his body became as transparent as a sheet of glass, though it also remained as solid as glass. So here, as I told you, the scientist's name is Griffin. So he had done many experiments, experiment after experiment, in a sense, many experiments to prove that human body can become invisible. He wanted to make human body invisible. For that he had done many experiments. Finally he had just invented a formula, and he had swallowed that drug which he had invented. Okay, the rarest drug which he had invented, he swallowed that drug, and immediately his body became as transparent as a sheet of glass. Like, we couldn't see him. Yeah, almost like a sheet of glass. Can you see anything? No. So in the same way here, his body became as transparent as a sheet of glass, but it remained as solid as glass. Okay, it was very tough. The body was tough, but it was invisible. So in this way, this scientist Griffin, he had taken the drug which was invented by him to make himself invisible. That's why the two boys couldn't see the person, but they could see these footprints. Okay, brilliant scientist though he was, Griffin was rather a lawless person. His landlord disliked him and tried to eject him. In revenge, Griffin set fire to the house. So here our scientist Griffin, he was a brilliant in the sense exceptionally clever or talented. So here our scientist was really a brilliant scientist, but he was a lawless person in the sense he never obeys law, a person who does not obey law. So though he was a brilliant scientist, he was a lawless person. And one day his landlord dislikes him, and he tried to eject him. Eject in the sense throw him away from his home. Okay, so because of that, here our scientist, he wanted to take revenge. So as his landlord, he tried to eject the scientist Griffin out. So he wanted to take revenge in the sense, you all know it children, to get even with somewhere for wrong done by him. Whatever the other person does, the same thing we wanted to do. In the same way, we wanted to do something wrong and give the same pain to the other person, isn't it? So in this way, here Griffin wanted to take revenge against his landlord. So what he did, you know children, he set fire to the house of his landlord. Though this Griffin was a very good, brilliant scientist, he was a lawless person, and when his landlord disliked him and thrown him out of his house, immediately he set fire to the house. To get away without being seen, he had to remove his clothes. Thus, it was that he became a homeless wanderer. Without clothes, without money, and quite invisible, until he happened to step in some mud and left footprints as he walked. So when he had set fire to the house, immediately he was thrown out. Just he became shelterless, isn't it? Homeless. So to get away without being seen. So when he had set the fire to the house, immediately the landlord will try to catch him, isn't it? So to escape from the landlord, he removed his clothes. So when he was wearing his clothes, he is visible. When he is wearing a cloth, he is visible. But to escape from the landlord, what did he do? He removed his clothes and he ran away, and because of that he became homeless wanderer in a sense, a person who roams here and there. So when he came out of the house by removing his clothes and he left everything, so he became homeless wanderer, without clothes, without money, without food, and also he became quite invisible. Nobody could see him and he only his steps could be seen whenever he set his feet in some mud. People can see his footprints, or else no one could see him. So as he had set fire to his landlord's house, when they were trying to catch him, he had removed his clothes and ran away. Because of them, he became homeless wanderer, and he became homeless wanderer without clothes, without money, without food, and finally he became invisible man. And whenever he had just put his feet in some mud or something, only his footprints were visible, or else nothing is visible. Yeah, to escape from his landlord, he removed his clothes and became invisible, isn't it? So he escaped easily enough from the boys who followed his footprints in London. So after becoming invisible, somehow his footprints were seen by the two boys, isn't it, children? So however, he had escaped from those two boys also, who had followed in the streets of London. But his adventures in the sense, an unusual and exciting or daring experience. So his adventures were by no means over. That means his adventures are not over. Certainly not over. That means he is still doing adventures. He had chosen a bad time of the year to wander about London without clothes. So he had chosen a bad time of the year. Because why it is a bad time of the year, I'll tell you, children. And see, he is wandering in the mid of this London without clothes, and it was a midwinter. Okay, why it is bad time of the year to wander in the sense, roam around. Okay, roam here and there. It was very bad time because it was midwinter. So in midwinter, how do you feel? You feel very chill, isn't it? So in that winter season, can you go out without clothes? Probably not, isn't it? We don't even dream of going out without clothes in midwinter. But what he had done here, he came out and started roaming or wandering without clothes, isn't it? And I have told you that though he is invisible, he could feel everything physically, isn't it? So now, as it was a midwinter, the air was bitterly in the sense, extremely cold, and he could not do without clothes. That means he couldn't tolerate that chillness. It was too cool. As I told you that he could feel all the senses physically, though he was invisible. As it was midwinter, it was bitterly, that is extremely cold, and he couldn't tolerate that chillness. And instead of walking about the streets, he decided to slip into a big London store for warmth. So he was walking on the streets, isn't it? He was walking on the streets of London. So instead of walking on the streets of London, just he decided to go into the one of the big London store, like one of the shopping malls you can see in the picture here, so that he could have some warmth there. Okay, some kind of a heat can be there. Like he couldn't tolerate this chillness, at least he can have some kind of a warmth if he gets into a one of the London stores. So finally he had decided to get into one of a big London store. Okay, you can see here. So when he had decided to get into the one of the biggest London stores, just he was wandering here and there and finding a big store, like a big shopping mall. And at that time, closing time arrived. So closing time arrived, and as soon as the doors were shut, Griffin was able to give himself the pleasure of clothing and feeding himself without regard to expense. So when he finally have chosen one big store, or you can say shopping mall here, finally he had gone there, and it was the closing time and everyone were coming out and they were closing it. So as soon as the doors were shut, so as soon as everyone have gone out and all the doors were shut, Griffin, he was able to give himself the pleasure of clothing. It means immediately he took all the new clothes and started wearing, and also started feeding himself without regard to expense. That means without thinking like what is the cost of this food item, or what is the cost of this shirt or pant. So in this way, without regard to expense, that means without thinking what is the cost of this, he started wearing the most comfortable clothes and also started feeding him, because the store was closed, isn't it? And he broke open boxes and wrappers and fitted himself out with warm clothes. So finally, after eating, he started breaking some open some boxes, and he opened it and he removed the wrappers in the sense covers of these clothes, and he started wearing the warm clothes to keep his body warm. Okay, and soon with shoes and overcoat and a wide brimmed edge in the sense a cap here like this. So he had worn shoes, overcoat and a hat, wide brimmed hat in the sense wide brimmed edge hat, and he became a fully dressed and visible person. So when he had worn all this hat and shoes, overcoat and all the dress, he became visible man. And now in the kitchen of the restaurant, he found cold meat and coffee, and he followed up the meal with sweets and wine and taken from the grocery store. Finally, he settled down to sleep on a pile of quilts. So when he had worn all this, just see here, he had worn shoes, overcoat and a wide brimmed in the sense big brimmed hat, like, you know, when you wear a hat, a kind of a what do we call, structure is seen here, it is so wide and it protects your face from sunlight and all. So he had worn that wide brimmed hat, and finally now he is totally dressed, and now when he is totally dressed, he is visible to everyone. And finally he went into the kitchen of the restaurant, and there he had found some cold meat and coffee, and he followed up the meal with the sweets. After eating that meat and coffee, he started eating sweets. He had worn beautiful clothes which keeps him warm, and then he started eating meal, and after meal he ate sweets and also drank wine taken from the grocery store. So he went to grocery store and there he had taken some wine and he drank it, and finally he settled down to sleep on a pile of quilts in some kind of a bed sheets. So he slept there. Okay, so the moment he decided to get into store, so during closing time he entered into the store, and all the staff, they have gone out and they closed the doors, and now it was a time for him to come out. He came out and he started using the pleasure of clothing. He wore clothes and started feeding himself the food without thinking about the cost, like or the expense, how much he had to pay. And he started breaking the boxes where the warm clothes were there. He removed the wrappers and started wearing. He wore shoes, overcoat and hat and everything, and finally he became fully dressed. The moment he wears the total dress, he becomes invisible. Anna children, so now he became totally visible man. After becoming visible man, he had gone to kitchen of the restaurant, and there he found cold meat and coffee. Nicely he had it, and after having the meal, he also had some sweets. After that he went to grocery store where he had taken some wine also. So when he had all comfortable clothes and his belly is full with the food, now he wanted to settle down to sleep. So he had settled down on a pile of quilts. Okay children, if only Griffin had managed to wake up in good time, all might have been well. That means here, Griffin, he had nice clothes, he used nice clothes and food and everything. So if he had woken up in a good time in the sense early, everything might have been well. But here he didn't wake early. Let us see. As it was, he did not wake up until the assistants were already arriving next morning. So till these assistants were coming in the next morning, he didn't wake up. And when he saw a couple of them approaching, he panicked. Panicked in the sense, got scared and nervous and began to run. So when he didn't wake up till these assistants or the salespersons have come into the store, and when he had seen these people, like a couple of them were approaching him, approaching whom here? Griffin. And immediately he panicked, that means he got scared and started running, and they naturally gave chase, that means they ran after him. And in the end, he was able to escape only by quickly taking off his newly found clothes. So to escape from them who were following him, what did he do? He again removed all these newly clothes which he had worn yesterday night, last night. Okay. So once more, he found himself invisible but naked in the chill January air. So, however, for the second time also he was saved, and again he became invisible. The only problem is he became naked in the chill January air. It is too cool. So again he has to face that chillness, isn't it? So if he had woken up early in the sense early to this, when this man have arrived, if he had woken up in correct time, he could have gone away from this store. But as he didn't woke early, these assistants, they have come and they have seen him, and he became too nervous and started running to save himself. And even those assistants, they chased him, and finally to escape from them, he had removed all the clothes again. Though he became invisible, he became naked in the chill January air. That means it was too cool. He has to bear that chillness. This time, he decided to try the stock. Stock in the sense, products like artificial products used by actors. Okay. Like the artificial products used by the actors. So he wanted to try this talk of a theoretical company in the hope of finding not only clothes but also something that would hide the empty space above his shoulder. Above his shoulder in the sense face and head area of the body. So shivering with cold, he hurried to Drury Lane, the center of the theater world. So after coming out of this store where he had been chased by these assistants, and finally to become invisible again, he had removed the clothes, and now he is suffering from the chillness of the January air. And finally this time he had decided to try the stock of a theoretical company, like the products used by these actors, okay, in hope of finding not only clothes but also something that would hide the empty space. See here, when he had worn normal clothes, he was looking like this, so he could wear cap, suit, tie, everything, but the space above his shoulders, that is the face and head was not covered. Because of that, he is appearing like a peculiar person. So now he don't want to be seen like that. So what he wanted to try now, he wanted to try some stock of the theoretical company, like, no, like how the actors use, okay, in hope that he will find something to cover the body above the shoulder, in the sense to cover the body of the face and head area. So shivering with cold, he hurried to a Drury Lane, the center of the theater world. So in the London, the center of theater world is Drury Lane. This is the place. So he hurried there in hoping to find some kind of a clothing to cover his face and head of the body. Yeah, he soon found a suitable shop. He made his way invisible upstairs and came out a little later, wearing bandages round his forehead, dark glasses, false nose, big bushy side whiskers, and a large hat. So finally, when he had gone to this Drury Lane to find a proper clothing, he had found a suitable shop where he could go, and he made his way invisible. So he went upstairs. Nobody could see him because he is visible. Sorry, he is invisible. Hana children. So he went upstairs and came out a little later. So finally, when he had chosen a shop, he went inside and he went upstairs. So as he was invisible, nobody have seen him. And a little later, like after some time, he came out wearing bandages. You can see here in the picture, he was wearing bandages round his forehead, dark glasses he was wearing. You see, he was wearing a spectacles of a dark color, and a false nose, something he had kept in a, to show him, to show people, like, no, give the shape of a nose, and big bushy side whiskers, and a large hat. So he had a side whiskers here in this picture, it is not there. He had a side whiskers and as well as a large hat. So in this way, when he had dressed in this way, people could see him. So to escape without being seen, he callously attacked the shopkeeper from behind, after which he robbed him of all the money he could find. So after wearing the dress, now again he had to escape from there because he didn't have any money, isn't it? So he attacked the shopkeeper from behind, and after that, this griffin, he robbed this shopkeeper all the money and he went away. Yeah, so in this way, the invisible man, the great scientist Griffin, he had made himself invisible in the mid of January, and finally, as he was suffering a lot from the chillness, first he had gone to a shopping mall where he could have a proper clothing and as well as a food. But as the attendants of the shop had seen him next day morning, he had removed all his clothes and he ran away, and again he became invisible. And now he wanted to try some stock of a filmy theater people or something, where he could hide his upper part of the shoulder, that is a face and head. And finally he had chosen one shop and he went inside invisible, and after some time he came with a proper dressing, where he had worn a coat and face was covered with a white cloth, and he had a black spectacles, hat, everything. But he couldn't pay the shopkeeper, so he tried to rob him from behind, and he had taken all the money and he ran away. So with this, we have ended the first part of the story, children. Hope you have understood it. If you have any doubts, please contact us so that we will clarify your doubts. The next part will be coming in the next video. Okay, children. Hari Om. Thank you.